That classic climax to any football season, the Army-Navy game, sees 100,000 jamming Philadelphia Stadium as the midshipmen march onto the field. Today's game is a toss-up between the two teams, but as usual, it's the pre-game color, like the cadets' measured strides, that lends special glamour to this 60-second meeting of the two service academies. Commander-in-Chief tosses for the team captains. As a Navy man, he proves impartial, for Army wins the toss. Crowd forgets that the president is in the stands as they are served up a thrilling game. Navy makes the only score in the first half as Greg Mather kicks the 32-yard field goal. To prove his neutrality, the president moves from the Army to the Navy side at halftime, flanked by an honor guard. Just after the second half starts, comes Army's big moment. Dick Eckert throws a long cross-field pass, and Tom Culver takes it in the clear and races for a 55-yard gain to Navy's 13. Then Al Ruschatz pulls through the Navy's 4. 9 yards to set up Army's lone touchdown. Ruschatz plows over, and Army holds a 7-3 lead. But Navy quickly gets up another head of steam as substitute quarterback Bob Hecht fades, shoots a pass to Jim Stewart, who waltzes down the sidelines for 38 yards to Army's 13. On the next play, another sub, Bill Ulrich, swings round right in, cuts back behind fine blocking, and goes over to put Navy back in the lead. In the last quarter, with Army looking for a third down pass, Johnny Sy breaks through the middle and charges 22 yards to the Army 26. Educated toe ensures another 3 points for Navy, and they hand the cadets their third straight loss in this classic, 13-7.